course.
Welcome to
the Bad Boys Food Club.
What are we cooking today, Tom?
We are cooking spaghetti, sausages, in the squash.
Let's get squashed.
Let's get squashing.
So instead of squash, we're using butternut pumpkin.
She was mighty difficult to chop in half.
Can we start by saying we're at Bad Boys HQ 2?
Oh yeah, the second kitchen. Lighting's not quite as good as yours.
It's like the QE2 of houses, isn't it?
Did you get it?
Yes. You seemed to have a sharp knife there, that's probably why.
You know.
You got through it pretty quick.
Thank you.
You know you're English when you use a teaspoon to hollow out a pumpkin.
It is very English.
It's a versatile instrument. Using the gritting technique here, Tom.
Like an avocado or a mango.
Show me yours and I'll show you mine.
Many have mocked the dicing technique, but yet again it comes through.
Gritting.
It's took a while. I'm pretty tired. Very hungry now. This is like that. It's the sound you're after.
What's the next step?
Yes, olive oil, salt, pepper.
Got enough in there?
I think so.
Yeah, you're right.
It's quite a lot. I like my squash really peppery.
I like you keep referring to it as squash. Squash is out of season at the moment. It is June. Apparently it's the wrong time to buy squash.
Really?
According to Harris from Harris Farm.
Oh, Harris. This is a fucking
What's your fun history fact, Tom?
Fun history facts. The brown shirts of Mussolini's secret army as a torture technique. They used to strap their prisoners into chairs, force their mouths open, and then force feed them olive oil, large quantities of olive oil, and then leave them for an hour or so, and then beat their kidneys and livers with baseball bats. Because there was so much oil in their system and stuff, their livers and kidneys would be a little bit messed up. So that was the technique they used to intimidate people into voting for fascism.
I thought that's what the Mediterranean diet was.
Yeah, I mean, a little bit less oil, a bit more fish, some coffee, and bunga bunga parties. Oh no, that was just Berlusconi.
Half a bowl? Oh shit.
The wine, careful.
Careful that.
I don't really know how to eat fennel or cook
or chop it, so let's just do it.
Just give it a go.
What do you do with it?
Just dice it. No, I think you have
dice?
To... Dice? You have to do something special with it. Like, I don't think you can eat the whole thing.
Yeah, I think you can.
Can you?
Yeah. I think it's like an onion. It says dice, that's fine.
Yeah.
Oh, look out, Oliver.
And back to the filming. That's going to be fun, the edit.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to dice very carefully.
My hand is the protection.
Carefully dice.
To make sure this pug doesn't eat your dinner.
It's alright, I know what to do with the broccoli.
Yeah, just put broccoli up. Cut into Florence.
Now Chuck loves broccoli.
Does he?
Don't. Yeah, he loves broccoli.
Can he eat it?
Yeah.
Oh.
Chuck. All gone.
Is one we prepared earlier.
It's a good thing about vegetarian food.
Yeah,
you just eat it.
It's very good.
Is it good? Oh, bye.
Pretty good.
Is it better than cooked? I don't know.
No, right. It is.
Hmm. Hot damn.
Pretty good.
That's tasty. All right.
All right. Pan's nice and hot now, so we're going to add the onion. Oh, and a bit of sausage, apparently. It's all right. And the fennel. Smoky.
Steaming, bro.
Woo. My mum's gonna hate that.
That's how we do it in the pros.
Dragon.
We're lucky we're the only ones eating this. But you know they're doing it in the real kitchens.
100% they are.
Yeah. They're douche blooming.
Douche blooms. I turn it down a little bit. Nice. Sausage, garlic, and chili flakes. Actually, you know what? I'm going to add the broccoli as well because.
Yeah, go on.
It says to blanch the broccoli, and we've not done that, so.
That's a big glaze this pan pretty gnarly.
Yeah.
Oh, chili flakes. You forgot something.
You got the stock in there?
Not yet. Oh!
Look out.
Hope you like spicy food then.
I'm like a spicy pasta. Tradish.
Tradish.
Tom's got the good stuff.
Oh yes! Half a cup of Parmesan.
Okay. Make it a whole.
Make it a whole cup, why not?
We only live once, and we're bad.
No, no, that's what my doctor keeps telling me. 2 tablespoons of cream cheese. Two tablespoons of pasta. The veggie stock. So the cream cheese is nearly melted in. So I'm just going to try a quick sausage, see what it tastes like. Oh my god.
Yeah?
Yep.
We're pretty good, eh?
We are pretty damn good. So I'm going to turn that off, the heat. Put the lid on. Pasta is done. Just going to add it
little by little into the mix.
Nice.
Right now,
here's the squash we roasted earlier.
Pumpkin. Look at that.
Gonna double cheese it now.
Bit of cheap parmo.
This is the only parmo.
It is, you're right.
And then this extra special fancy pecorino that Dan picked up today.
Why is it extra special?
Because it was expensive. There we go.
Beautiful.
Oh. Mate, I can't wait for this.
This looks sensational.
This looks amazing. I'm gonna dig in.
Do it. How is it?
That's sensational. That's incredible.
It looks impressive.
Right. Definitely way too much chili.
Too much chili?
Yeah, but
what about the pesto?
The pesto's great. And let's try a little bit of
the fennel?
It's a bit peppery. Maybe that's the chili with the pepper. That's what's killing me, but
got a bit of pumpkin there?
Alright. The pumpkin is so good with it. 100%.
Awesome. I'm very excited.
Well, it's a Bad Boys take on a Smith and Daughters classic, so
kudos.
Good.
How's that one? Oh, you didn't taste it.
No, it's full. Le sausage. So good.
All right, here we go. This is what you did?
Yeah.
Right on the fork. Yum!
I know!
Yum! It's not too spicy.
No.
The pumpkin gives it a bit of a sweetness. Oh, this is good. Bad Boys for life.
Yeah!
Yeah.
Represent! Alright. Should we eat a little bit and then maybe take this,
to the streets.
The streets. Yes.
Street food.
Aussie street food.
Oh yeah.
Done the bad way.